Welcome to the virtual open house for the Highway 49 Safety Assessment Report. This is the second video in the series and will provide information about collision data along the corridor. Data was collected from the Caltrans Traffic Accident Surveillance and Analysis System, which we call TASIS, for the period from January 2010 through December 2019. The corridor has been divided into four distinct segments. Segment 1 runs from Interstate 80 to Dry Creek Road and is a 6-lane urban arterial through the town of Auburn. This segment is 4.2 miles long. Segment 2 is from Dry Creek Road to Wolf and Combi Roads and is a 4-lane rural highway with a continuous 2-way left turn lane with speeds primarily posted at 65 miles per hour. This segment is 6.2 miles long. Segment 3 runs from Wolf and Combi Roads to the Allison Ranch and LaBarre Meadows Roads intersection. This is a 2-lane section of highway with passing lanes and is 8.5 miles long. Segment 4 is from the Allison Ranch and LaBarre Meadows Roads intersection to McKnight Way. This segment is a 2-lane highway that transitions to a 4-lane freeway at McKnight Way. This segment is 3 miles long. When we looked at the collision patterns, we noted that for the period between January 2010 and December 2019, there were over 2,300 collisions, 33 fatalities, and 816 injury collisions. Segment 1 had the highest number of collisions at 1,266 with 11 fatalities. 8 of these fatalities involved pedestrians on this urban highway segment. The majority of collisions are attributed to congestion. Segment 2 had 414 collisions and saw the highest number of fatalities, totaling 16. This is a freeway segment with a primary posted speed limit of 65 miles per hour. Segment 3 experienced 534 collisions and 6 fatalities. Segment 4 had 182 collisions and 0 fatalities. Upon reviewing the collision data and the types of collisions occurring, 51% were rear-end collisions. These are primarily related to congestion, and 63% of collisions in Segment 1 in Auburn were rear-end collisions. 15% were broadside and 11% were sideswipe. These are primarily attributed to vehicle turning movements from motorists making left turns across traffic or right turns into traffic. 11% of collisions were categorized as hit objects, meaning the vehicle left the roadway and collided with guardrail, a tree or pole, etc. 4% of collisions along the corridor were head-on collisions primarily caused by cross-center line incidents where vehicles crossed into the opposing lane of traffic. However, these collisions can also be related to turning movements, primarily at traffic signals. The California Highway Patrol classifies collisions based on the area of impact on the involved vehicles. So if two vehicles impact nose to nose during a left turning movement, it will be classified as a head-on collision. The primary collision factor noted by CHP in its reports was speeding, accounting for 43% of highway collisions. California Vehicle Code Section 22350, Basic Speed Law, stipulates it is the driver's responsibility to only drive as fast as the current roadway conditions permit. The vast majority of speeding-designated collisions are rear-end collisions resulting from driver behavior. Therefore, these incidents are not always indicative of someone driving above the posted speed limit. The second highest contributor to collisions was other than driver. These collisions were most often seen in segments 3 and 4 between Wolf and Combi Roads and McKnight Way. Examples of this include collisions with animals in the roadway, vehicle mechanical failure, driver medical emergencies, or debris in the roadway. Failure to yield contributed to 15% of corridor collisions. This is typically your standard intersection-related collision with broadsides and sideswipes. Other factors that were evaluated during the assessment include weather. 75% of highway collisions occurred during clear weather and 73% during daylight hours. 86% of collisions occurred when the pavement was dry. This indicates that many incidents are related to the daytime work commute. 67% of collisions involve two or more vehicles, but single vehicle collisions are more common in the rural segments of 2, 3, and 4 between Dry Creek Road and McKnight Way. Signalized intersections also see a higher percentage of collisions, but the severity is often lower because the collisions tend to be at low speeds or rear ends or side swipes during a turning movement. In addition, more collisions occur during the autumn months. Some factors that may contribute to collisions include first rain events, the start of the school year, and the change from daylight savings time. Motorists used to commuting during daylight hours are suddenly traveling in the dark. Animal migration also contributes to collisions along the corridor. Making left turns from unsignalized intersections also requires patience, especially during peak travel hours. Drivers may have difficulty judging available gaps in traffic and how fast ongoing vehicles are traveling. Driver sight distance may also be impacted by terrain, vegetation, and traffic on the roadway. Finally, in passing lane segments, there are higher collision rates at the merge points where the lane ends, primarily due to driver behavior such as failing to yield to another vehicle. Thank you for taking the time to review our presentation. The Highway 49 Safety Assessment Report can be viewed online at hwy49safety.com. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to contact us at Caltrans District 3, Program/Project Management, 703 B Street, Marysville, California, 95901, attention Highway 49 Safety Assessment, or hwy49safety@dot.ca.gov. Thank you.